Hey everyone, and welcome back to another Dragon Ball Z Dokkan Battle video. Today we're taking a look at the upcoming LR Goku Black. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Hit that subscribe, of course, if you are new for more content, as well as that notification so you don't miss anything we upload here on the channel. Now, that being said, we are using the private server, quote-unquote, called Trident, so you guys can check it out. Link is down below. No, the Goku Black is not live in the game yet. He will be going live soon in the game, though. But I want to go ahead and start things out by kind of explaining what this character can do, and then afterwards we'll transition into actual gameplay form. So we don't actually have flat-out translations. A lot of our translators are kind of just MIA right now, probably busy. It's a weird time for data download as well. Came several hours earlier than normal. But we'll have to kind of infer what the character does based off of some Google translation stuff and then also the pre-existing card. So he is the Awakening for the free-to-play STR Zamasu live in the game. Yes, this is JP only for now. This is part of the anniversary global players, if you didn't know. So Time Traveler's category. Now, that actually does get bumped up to 77% across the board for the Goku Black in terms of his leader skill. That is all that he has, 3 keys, 77%. He has largely the same passive as the Zamasu as well. So the super attacks we'll come back to, but the passive is now 50% attack and defense at the start of the turn, and then key plus one with each attack received up to 5 as the maximum is the new passive. Also, he does do a guaranteed additional attack. On this card, it actually was a 10% chance. That was just a chance. It was not medium or great or anything like that. But just on this card, it was that. But it does appear, and also shout out to Hydros, on the translations for this card now, it does say he has a medium chance to do a super attack now from the passive, which would make sense. You give him a more likely chance to do a super attack from that guaranteed additional that he does. Now, for the last part of his passive, he does have the ability to get another 20% attack and defense up to a maximum of 50 every time you stab the enemy. I'm assuming that means attack, but again, Google translation can be kind of annoying. So the super attacks are colossal and mega colossal from what I have heard. Obviously, that would be really weird if they weren't. So the 12 key does lower defense, and then 18 key raises defense for one turn. So pretty much, again, ideally, very identical card as he would normally be. That's normally how it goes. Not much difference, though, in terms of what the character is. You can even see everything we kind of just read in terms of how he works, 50% up to 5 key, and then when there's two or more enemies, which is actually... that part is actually kind of annoying because it's not actually really easy to do that part. I'm going to have to drop out of this event shortly here to kind of show that last part, because when there's two or more enemies, he does get the opportunity to perform the additional attack, and That's the only part that's restricted, by the way, like that. It does look like the last part with the additional 20% attack and defense, allowing him to get up to 100% is not restricted. So if you're versus an event, which is majority of the events where you're versus one enemy, he can only get up to, apparently, 5 key self-sufficient, and then on top of that, getting access to, and by the way, I'll look at the links, getting access to 100% to attack and defense, which is not bad on the surface, right? These are good links as well. Not bad on the surface. It just kind of is annoying to restrict something like that behind needing to be versus more than one enemy, which, again, in most cases, you're not going to be fighting more than one enemy at a time. But anyways, here we go. We'll see how things go. Goku is getting the first attack, and then we do transition back to Goku Black. His ki did go up. Here's a 12 key super. Actually really happy that we have this Goku Black. And by the way, his name is a little bit different. His name is different. It is Goku Black, and it has parentheses. I'm assuming that it's maybe like Zamasu and then parentheses Goku Black, or like Goku Black Kai outfit or something like that, right? But he can be ran on the team with other base Goku Blacks, so that's nice. They could have easily just called him Goku Black and obviously pretty much ruined team compositions for this character. Also, he kind of reminds me a little bit, just a little bit of EZA Goku Black with the key stacking mechanic that he has here. You can already see that just from that sequence of attacks, his key and stuff was able to stack nicely. So I want to get him alongside the STR Zamasu. The reason why is because he still links incredibly well with him. And at some point, I want to get him alongside Rose and kind of just do multiple things with him. But again, we're not going to spend the entirety of the video playing against the Goku event. I do want to still get that additional attack, which is going to be very nice because, assuming that it is when you attack, right, it is going to be really nice because he'll be able to get to that additional 50 pretty much within a turn, right? If you get, if you get the additional super from the potential system or something like that, additional normal, you should still get, from the next time that he shows up anyway, the second turn he shows up, you should get that 50% maximum already. And that's very quick to get that additional boost, right? So here we go. Look at all the key he already has. He does have a lot of support, though, nonetheless, but he does have a ton of key. So here we go, starting out looking at the stats, 130,000 defense on this exact setup. We're going to go ahead and get him these orbs here. He's going to get the Ultra Super. We don't have to worry about her in the front spot. She's not going to beat this, so that's all I really care about. So here we go. I actually don't know. The thing about her is you can never really tell like what passives she's offering because of the chance and stuff like that. But anyways, here we go. So she does crit. Not a big deal. Here's Goku Black's attack. 2 million attack stat. Can definitely get better than that. Here's the 18P super. Okay. It's not anything fancy. Not anything fancy at all. But it's not bad. It's not bad. So, by the way, there was a new movie. I might have uploaded a video already. But it does appear that there's going to be a LR Broly, Chi-Lai, Lemo trio card that I'm assuming is summonable because there's nothing in the game about it being free or anything like that or grindable outright. And it's talking about part two of the anniversary, which would make sense that we get a couple of LRs, right? One of them being free, one of them being summonable, potentially more stuff, right? But they're still doing the thing where they're pulling from Dragon Ball Super Broly and then also the Future Punks arc as well of Super, where they're just bringing out content from both at the same time. Courtesy of the 5-year anniversary theme. Obviously, that's why we got the two LRs, Gogeta and Vegito, as well at the same time. So, if you guys haven't seen that, I'll leave it down below. If it's not up yet, it will be up very shortly because it's a very short thing to upload, right? It doesn't take very long. So, that being said, I'm really excited about that as well in particular, but that is not in the files yet. There's nothing about that. In fact, you can honestly say it's not even really quote-unquote confirmed yet because we can't even really see it, but obviously, it should be happening. So, that's what I will say. So, here we go. Here's a look at the stats and stuff like that. He does have Cold Judgment and things like that that are nice to have on this guy. We do not have access to Legendary Power, which I can get later on whenever the LR shows up again on the following turn with these STR Zamasus. So 2.3, his key stacking should be done about now or really soon, in fact. No additional super anything like that. You can see the defense raise in terms of how much damage he takes before and after. He still took a good bit of damage there, but it's nice to at least get a defense raising mechanic on there. And I'm assuming it's just a regular raise, which would translate to a 30% increase for one turn, right? And on top of that, though, again, 100%. I don't know if the passives multiply into each other. That could be a possible thing. I've never been good with determining whether or not that's the case. But if you guys do know, let me know. But anyways, yeah, he's not a bad card. I don't think he's anything special, but he's not a bad card. So here we go. We do float out the LR. And I need one more rotation with Zamasu after this next one to get the right setup. I misread how that little pie chart was looking. Anyways, so here we go. We're going to go here, and the following time around, we'll finally have everything the way that we want it to be. Now, one thing I could do here is let STR Rosé super in the front spot to get that ally attack increase mechanic, but I don't think that I will, in fact. I think I'm just going to kind of stick to my guns and maintain the rotation. So here we have access to Nightmare, which is, in this instance, triggering every single link that he has, except for having access to Legendary Power. And again, he can be on the team with base Goku Blacks. I just did not opt to run any on my team because I didn't feel it was necessary. Okay, here we go. So next time around, he'll have access to Legendary Power, and that'll be pretty much it. In fact, it doesn't really matter too much if we get Legendary Power. I actually might just kind of drop out from here. Yeah, after this turn, we're going to drop out and go to another event where we have multiple enemies, and we want to get that additional super chance kicking in there. So we'll see what we can do. So 2 million attack, still kind of going with that. So not bad, though. Again, not bad damage. An additional, and then boom, there we go. That was a potential system, if you couldn't tell. He does not have access to any real additional investment in terms of his potential system. A lot of it's all crit investment, which isn't that big of a deal because the 12 key does lower defense anyway. And if you do an additional super, it does default to the 12 key super, which for better or worse, that's how that mechanic works. Personally, on him, I would have liked for it to be a defense raise, but then we'd be sacrificing potential defense raise on the 18. And then, of course, pre-existing Zamasu didn't work that way, so it wouldn't have made too much sense anyway. So that being said, we do move on, and we're going to take on another. Off the top of my head, there's some, but I can't really think of one. You know, let's play Metacooler is normally my go-to because he has that one phase that's kind of later in the event. So we're going to just take this one on. Yeah, we're going to take on Metacoolers and then kind of see what we can do. Again, we are using Potara. There are a number of teams he can be on, most notably like Time Travelers and stuff like that. And, you know, he'd be good on any team comp you really want. Depending on how you want to build the team around him, you're fine. You also can do the full Tsuburashi team, and you're fine with that too. So here we go. He got a key on the board, I guess. That's cool, right? Here we go. Oh, nice. We already started off with one of his best possible rotations, so I can actually show legendary power immediately with also getting max key. The downside is he doesn't have that additional, 50% built up yet, but I can show it at least a little bit here, so we're going to go for it. Going to take some solid damage in the front spot, I imagine. He doesn't have big bad bosses, so there's nothing like that really to worry about, not to manage. So that's kind of interesting. We get the additional potential system kicking in for Zamasu. And he crit again, okay. He crit right the first time, right? Am I crazy? He did. Here we go. And not a KO, and then the LR does need to finish it off. Every LR. All right, so next turn, this isn't the one that has all of them, right? Yeah, there's one more turn. So I get one more kind of like opportunity to kind of set up here a little bit. Actually, does Ringguy have time? Was off rotation. That's actually really good. Okay, so I want to purposely avoid kind of just... No. I messed that up. I need to completely just beat this turn, huh? Yeah, I need to beat this turn. I don't think it really matters, though. I don't know if I would have beat it. I guess it would have maybe. It depends on the LR what they would have done. But I don't know if it matters too much. Anyways, it's fine. It's fine. They got an additional normal crit. Okay. Yeah, it's fine. I kind of messed that up. I don't think their super would have done enough anyway. But it's fine. Yeah, the reason why I said that was because Supreme Kai's time was there. And I floated Gawasu and Zamasu this turn around. Okay. They're about 1 million attack. That's pretty high, actually. Oh, they beat it. Nice. Oh, they got their additional attack, huh? I never see that. I never get that. The way I use them, I never get their additional attack. That would make sense. The additional attack increases what they get. Okay. So, here we go. I will let you attack here. Oh, I got to be real careful with this guy because he himself might potentially just get the additionals and just kind of shred. So, here we're gonna go with that. And we'll let you attack here. All right. Pretty much max key, so that's pretty nice. Now I'll let her actually attack here so she can seal just in case. Gotta still be kind of wary of this rotation. A lot of times they like to like super and stuff like that, and you can get pretty crazy. So we'll see how that works. 70, yeah, that's what I'm talking about. A lot of times they like to super, and you just start taking a lot of damage really fast. If I had big bad bosses, I'd be very happy though. Unfortunately, I do not. So, okay, this guy actually, he's gonna get his additional. Is it gonna be a super? It is not. Will he get a third though? He will not. Okay, that's fine. So 2.3, very powerful. Very, very powerful so far for him. This is the highest attack we've seen all video. Ah, we didn't get a super. Come on, one more. Okay, so that means that next turn I've got to go out of my way to make sure that we don't beat it. So I'm going to do the same thing with the LR. The good news is the Goku Black LR should have, if I recall correctly, all of his attack increases by now. If not, he's kind of like one shy. In which case, obviously, immediately he's going to get that last one, right? So that's not so bad. I, unfortunately, am in a weird spot. I wish I floated Rosé last time instead of now. That would have been nice to get Rosé on that rotation instead. We're going to attack here. Yeah, we're gonna definitely get the opportunity to see one more time, especially because of healing kicking in here, at least one more time with the LR Goku Black and Zamasu. By the way, if you guys are enjoying, be sure to give a thumbs up. Today's video like goal, 1,000 likes. Make sure you get us there if you guys are interested in the content on the channel. So here we go. Taking a super back. 90K and a lot of supers. Cool. Excellent. Excellent. Okay. And that actually will be our wrap because I feel like at that point we've pretty much shown everything we need to show. So this time around we have Zamasu and Gawasu. So a full Zamasu setup, in fact. Didn't plan it, but it worked out that way. Okay, we're going to seal you. And then for you, oh, you're not a sealer. I'm thinking about the other Zamasu. For you, we're going to go ahead and attack here. Get all of that. Two key shy, not a big deal. 130,000 defense, do have support. Also Trident, this is why this is a thing. So yes, no, it's not available. Here we go. We're going to do that. And boom. So no attack support, it makes a really big difference. Really big difference when you have no attack support. All right. I might actually honestly be able to push this to where I get Zamasu, triple Zamasu setup again. I might be able to do it. I don't know. Freaking give me supers, man. Oh, really? That's it? That's really anticlimactic. That's really anticlimactic. Two or more. It's really anticlimactic that I'm not getting any supers at all. Not even the third one, though, for the potential. That's very anticlimactic and very unfortunate. So I can try one more time, maybe. 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 I don't know, actually. These guys are going to probably push themselves to a super. There's just way too much, like, kind of here. Yellow drop? Yeah, I might be able to. I don't know, man. It's going to be really close. Really close if I can maybe do it one more time. Shout out to these coolers for constantly healing. And these are the two best coolers anyway, so that makes it a little easier, right? Ah, he ruined it. Great, he crit. He ruined it. Okay, well, this is done. So what we'll get to see here is we'll still get to see that setup, right? But we'll get the opportunity to see the triple Zamasu setup versus only one enemy, unfortunately. So what I'll do for this one is put you in the second spot, let you stay alongside Rosé, and for the rest of this video, I'm going to let these two stay here, and hopefully Supreme Kai of Time comes back pretty soon. She should, and I'll get to see like kind of like a double support setup with Goku Black attacking in the front spot, and that'll be pretty much our wrap. Because it doesn't really necessarily matter. He doesn't necessarily need to be alongside the SDR Zamasu. It's just, again, his best link buddy in terms of getting things like Cold Judgment and stuff like that. Of course he crit. Of course he crit. Anyways, here we go. And this should be the final round, right? Yes, it is. Okay. Supreme Kai of Time is actually a few turns away, so I'm going to float her here, give you this. Give you this, and we're actually kind of close to a Dokkan attack. I'll give you the green. Yeah, kind of close to a Dokkan attack. So we get legendary power. Yeah, I didn't really comment on anything because of how things worked out last turn. Everybody decided that they wanted to just smoke the event, so I didn't really comment. Yeah, this is kind of what happens. It can happen sometimes. So here we go. This is our last turn because they're definitely going to beat this. I wouldn't be surprised if he didn't beat it. So thank you all for tuning in. Hope you guys enjoyed. Hit that subscribe, of course, if you're new for more content, as well as my notifications so you don't miss anything we upload here on the channel. Have an awesome day, and I'll catch all of you in the next one.